Hi guys, my name's Emma and let's talk spooky stuff. Today I want to talk to you guys about a film from 2011. It is a film from Norway and is called The Monitor or Baby Call. The film is about a mother and son who move into an apartment block after a messy separation from the father who has been abusing the child. But not everything is what it seems. When the mother buys a baby monitor to put in the child's room so she can monitor him while he's sleeping, and she starts to hear voices through the baby monitor. She's told by the store that she might be hearing a different frequency, and she can hear this abuse going on in her apartment building. I'm gonna start off by saying this film is great, but it's great for many different reasons. The film has maybe three different plots going at one time, and they follow the mother, the son and his friend, I want to say, and then also the mum meets someone along the way that kind of interacts with her and gives her kind of like a sounding board to relay all the information that she is seeing and she's not believing and she's not sure what's real and not. I do want to say it isn't a Fight Club situation where you're like, what is going on at any given time and are they same person? Is that a ghost of who, of Christmas past? It's not like that. It's done in a very clever, strange way. Not that Fight Club isn't. Fight Club's very clever. But it's very strange and spooky and eerie. This film is not a flat out horror by any means. It's more of a thriller, and the rawness of the film really bring this strange, spooky, stale element to the film. I'm not gonna ruin the film for you, but it has several different meanings and it is a lot to do with a mother and son relationship, and you can see that mirrored in three different ways during the film, so it's really interesting to look out for. When I was watching this the first time, I had no idea really that that was going on. The second time, it's really interesting to think about what the movie is trying to say to you, because a lot of what you hear and what you see may be kind of intertwined in a way. Am I speaking in riddles? Probably. What I'm trying to say is this film has a lot of hidden messages and themes, and you really need to look out for them. The film is shot beautifully and the acting is superb, which I think really gave that raw feeling. If you've seen Personal Shopper, it kind of reminds me of that with the staleness. It's not very theatrical, there's no crazy music, and the characters are the things that kind of thread all of the scenes together. It's not really a huge montage type film. It's very in your face, really like fluoro lighting and just raw. It's so stripped back, and that's what makes it so eerie. The director for this film also did Next Door, and if you watch my 31 Days of Horror, you'll see my review on that. And it has the kind of same feeling where reality and fiction kind of bend together. And I like that feeling, but I felt like they are both really great independent films. Obviously, I don't feel like it's the director trying to do the same thing again, but this film is such a beautiful, secluded film about mother and son's relationship and the outside world and how terrifying it is. This film really reminds me of Dark Water meets Personal Shopper. I don't know if anyone else will see that in it, but that's definitely the feeling I get. If you guys are keen on foreign horror, I definitely recommend putting this one on your list, and let me know down below what you guys think of this one. If you've seen it, do you like The Monitor? I think it's fantastic and I highly, highly recommend it to you guys who want to watch a film that you have to think about and you can get a lot out of. I'm gonna give this one a 7 out of 10 personal, a scare score of like 2 out of 10, an originality score of 8 out of 10. I thought that the subplots, the way they told the story, was just so original and so clever, and it really had you guessing what the next scene was even going to try and tackle. I hope you guys enjoyed this review. If you guys like reviews like this, please give it a thumbs up, and I'll talk to you guys very soon. Stay spooky. Bye.